Hi there! Welcome to Pallet University. So I had a totally different video planned for today, but after yesterday's marathon of a stream from the Pokemon Company on their YouTube and Twitch channel, I believe they did on Twitch as well, I wanted to break that down a little bit and talk about some of the things that were in it. But more importantly, talk about the whole thing itself. So before we get into anything that actually was shown in the stream, Sonia, you and I need to have a little talk. So if you did not know, this whole thing was framed as Sonia, who is the professor's assistant in the Galar region. This was something that she set up, essentially like a trap camera that she set up in this Glimwood Tangle to see what kind of Pokemon live there. And, you know, props to you, Sonia. To my knowledge, this is the first time that anyone in the Pokemon community research community has done that. But real quick, I'm going to break fourth wall here and talk to Pokemon Company. First of all, thank you for, like, treating this game differently. You know, not releasing everything all at one time, which has been really awesome. And the fact that you're willing to treat this game like an actual world itself, and the scientists in it, as actual scientists who go out and do science things, is really cool for me. And for a lot of other people who study the lore and science-y type things in this game, I think that's really great. But now back to Sonia. So, I understand that you're just the assistant. Maybe this was something you did on your own, maybe this is something that the professor told you to do. Either way, let me give you some suggestions. The biggest of which is to use sort of like a motion sense camera. That way, you don't have to record for literally a day and then force yourself and the rest of us to watch 24 hours worth of footage, most of which is just empty space and some rustling bushes. Saves you and all of us so much time. So just for future reference. Anyway, moving on to what was actually discussed, or not really discussed, shown in this stream. The biggest thing, and I'm just gonna throw this out there first, is the pretty much reveal of Galarian Ponyta and Galarian Rapidash. Galarian Rapidash wasn't shown. You could hear it at the end, and it's pretty much heavily implied that it's, you know, if Ponyta's changed, then Rapidash has changed. That's pretty much how it's been since, you know, they started doing regional variants in Generation 7. Here we have a nice shot of Galarian Ponyta, which most people are assuming that's either Pure Fairy or Fire Fairy. I'd be fine with either, although I'm more inclined to believe that it's Pure Fairy, because I think that Galarian Rapidash is going to be a Pegasus, so it's going to be Fairy Flying, which is a cool typing that we don't have yet. But I have a hard time believing that they'll go from Fire Fairy Galarian Ponyta to Flying Fairy Galarian Rapidash. I feel like they'll just go Pure Fairy to Fairy Flying. Personally, I really, really like this design. I'm guaranteed that it just got, like, the entire, like, My Little Pony community. If they weren't already into Pokemon, they're like, this is my new jam. But, you know, joking aside, I really like the way this looks. I like the way that the mane and the tail light up when it's excited, or when it does something, most likely when it uses a move, or when you're playing with it in the Pokemon camp. I'm also really interested in the fact that they gave it a horn. I understand that it's supposed to be like a unicorn, which makes sense for, you know, the mythology of, you know, the countries in the UK and the British Isles, but that's typically something, you know, they've always just had Rapidash as the unicorn, which is why I think they're going to take Rapidash a step further and make it a Pegasus in its Galarian form. Other than that, the Pokemon Company keeps trolling us with Impidimp without actually revealing it. They have not officially revealed any information about Impidimp. The only thing that's been released about it is some people that have played the demo that have been, you know, at various, you know, PAX conferences or events like that. Impidimp is in the demo, and it's known to be a fairy dark type, but Pokemon Company has revealed nothing about it, but yet continues to throw it in the Pokemon Camp trailer. And now this live stream, because Impidimp was everywhere. Impidimp basically had the role of obscuring our view of the Galarian Ponyta for like most of the whole stream. Honestly, I kind of really like the fact that they're trolling us like this. Personally, I think it's their social media people having fun, is really what I think it is. And good for them. Have fun with your marketing. It's literally your job. Why not have fun with it? Although, other than the Ponyta and Impidimp shenanigans, we didn't really get a ton. We got the confirmation of a handful of new Pokemon in the game, them being Phantump and Trevenant, and Morlul and Shenotic. There were a couple cries that could be heard that belonged to various Pokemon. Cottonee was shown, but we already knew that Cottonee and Whimsicott were in the game. Pikachu was shown a couple times, but we... obviously, that was in the first trailer. It's Pikachu. However, at one point, and I'll see if I can find it, because it's really hard to sift through that entire clip, 24 hours long, to find it, but it was around 2:30, a little before 2:30 Eastern time, when I heard what I'm almost positive was Tangrowth's cry. And if I can find it, I'll put it in right here. If I can't, oh well. So, I also think that Tangrowth and Tangela will be in the game. This seems like a pretty, it would make sense for them to go in like a really dense forest like this. So I think that would make sense. Plus, Tangrowth is a really super important Pokemon to the competitive scene, and Pokemon seems to be caring a lot more about the competitive scene this generation. So I think it would make sense for Tangrowth to be included in the game. And that's literally it. This entire 24 hours summed up in what's probably going to be like a 5 to 7 minute video. Oh well, thank you very much for watching. If you haven't already, please make sure to watch this video. I need you guys' opinion on something, so please let me know your thoughts on it. Give that a watch, let me know in the comments down below of either this video or that video, doesn't really matter. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to follow us on Twitter at Pallet_U to keep up on all things Pokemon science. And as always, there's a time and place for everything.